This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A water tube boiler, also spelled water tube and water tube, is a type of boiler in which water circulates in tubes heated externally by the fire. Fuel is burned inside the furnace, creating hot gas which heats water in the steam generating tubes in smaller boilers. Additional generating tubes are separate in the furnace, while larger utility boilers rely on the water-filled tubes that make up the walls of the furnace to generate steam. The heated water then rises into the steam drum here. Saturated steam is drawn off the top of the drum in some surfaces. The steam will re-enter the furnace through a superheater to become superheated. Superheated steam is defined as steam that is heated above the boiling point at a given pressure. Superheated steam is a dry gas and therefore used to drive turbines. Since water droplets can severely damage turbine blades, cool water at the bottom of the steam drum returns to the feedwater drum via large bore downcomer tubes, where it preheats the feedwater supply in large utility boilers. The feedwater is supplied to the steam drum and the downcomers supply water to the bottom of the waterwalls to increase economy of the boiler. Exhaust gases are also used to preheat the air blown into the furnace and warm the feed water supply. Such water tube boilers in thermal power stations are also called steam generating units. The older fire tube boiler design, in which the water surrounds the heat source and gases from combustion pass through tubes within the water space, is a much weaker structure and is rarely used for pressures above 24.28 Thornycroft. 29 Forced circulation boiler. 210 Other types. 3 See also. 4 References. 5 External links. Applications. The ability of water tube boilers to generate superheated steam makes these boilers particularly attractive in applications that require dry, high pressure, high energy steam, including steam turbine power generation, owing to their superb working properties. The use of water tube boilers is highly preferred in the following major areas: variety of process applications in industries, chemical processing divisions, pulp and paper manufacturing plants, refining units. Besides, they are frequently employed in power generation plants where large quantities of steam ranging up to 500-160 LMS. 6399 Fury rebuilt completely after a fatal accident. LNER 10000 Hush using a Yarrow boiler, rather than Schmidt. Never successful and re-boilered with a conventional boiler. Hybrids. A slightly more successful adoption was the use of hybrid water tube, fire tube systems, as the hottest part of a locomotive boiler is the firebox. It was an effective design to use a water tube design here and a conventional fire tube boiler as an economizer, i.e. preheater in the usual position. One famous example of this was the USA Baldwin 4-102 No. 60,000, built in 1926, operating as a compound at a boiler pressure of 2,400 kilopascals 350. The only railway use of water tube boilers in any numbers was the Broughton boiler, invented in Austria in 1902 by Johann Broughton and found in rare examples throughout Europe. Hungary, though, was a keen user and had around 1,000 of them, like the Baldwin. This combined a water tube firebox with a fire tube barrel. The original characteristic of the Broughton was a long steam drum running above the main barrel, making it resemble a Flamand boiler in appearance. Road, while the traction engine was usually built using its locomotive boiler as its frame. Other types of steam road vehicles such as lorries and cars have used a wide range of different boiler types. Road transport pioneers Goldsworthy Gurney and Walter Hancock both used water tube boilers in their steam carriages around 1830. Most undertype wagons used water tube boilers. Many manufacturers used variants of the vertical cross tube boiler, including Atkinson, Clayton, Garrett and Sentinel. Other types include the Clarkson thimble tube and the Foden O-type wagons. Pistol-shaped boiler steam fire engine makers such as Meriwether usually used water tube boilers for their rapid steam raising capacity. Many steam cars used water tube boilers, and the Bolsover Express Company even made a water tube replacement for the Stanley Steamer fire tube boiler. Design variations. This section does not cite any sources. Please help improve this section by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. December 2014 Learn how and when to remove this template message. D-type boiler. The D-type is the most common type of small to medium-sized boilers, similar to the one shown in the schematic diagram. It is used in both stationary and marine applications. It consists of a large steam drum vertically connected to a smaller water drum, aka mud drum, via multiple steam generating tubes. These are surrounded by walls made up of larger water-filled tubes, which make up the furnace M-type boilers. The M-type boilers were used in many U.S. World War II warships, including hundreds of Fletcher-class destroyers. Three sets of tubes form the shape of an M, and create a separately fired superheater that allows better superheat temperature control in addition to the mud drum shown on a D-type boiler. An M-type has a water screen header and a waterwall header at the bottom of the two additional rows of vertical tubes and downcomers. Low water content. The low water content boiler has a lower and upper header connected by water tubes that are directly impinged upon from the burner. This is a furnace-less boiler that can generate steam and react quickly to changes in load. Babcock coal-fired in power stations, they also became widespread in industries that produced combustible waste and required process steam. Paper pulp mills could burn waste bark, sugar refineries their bagasse waste. It is a horizontal type of boiler. Yarrow main article, Yarrow boiler. End view of a Yarrow boiler named after its designers, the then Poplar-based Yarrow shipbuilders. This type of three-drum boiler has three drums in a delta formation connected by water tubes. The drums are linked by straight water tubes, allowing easy tube cleaning. This does, however, mean that the tubes enter the drums at varying angles. A more difficult joint to cock outside the firebox, a pair of cold leg pipes between each drum act as downcomers due to its three drums. The Yarrow boiler has a greater water capacity, hence, this type is usually used in older marine boiler applications. Its compact size made it attractive for use in transportable power generation units during World War II. In order to make it transportable, the boiler and its auxiliary equipment, fuel oil heating, pumping units, fans, etc., turbines, and condensers were mounted on wagons to be transported by rail. White Forster. The White Forster type is similar to the Yarrow, but with tubes that are gradually curved. This makes their entry into the drums perpendicular, thus simpler to make a reliable seal. Thornycroft. End view of a Thornycroft boiler designed by the shipbuilder John I Thornycroft. See also three-drum boiler. Clarkson thimble tube boiler. Corner tube boiler. Internally rifled boiler tubes, also known as serve tubes. References. https://lorisorsorg/pub/us/code/iber/asmebpvcv2010pdf Boiler efficiency, water tube boilers. Power Stauffer P. E. Steam engines operating cycle atmospheric watt. Cornish compound uniflow valves. Valves slide D slide piston drop. Coreless poppet sleeve bash. Valve gear. Gab Stevenson link. Joy Walsharts. Alan Baker. Coreless Lentz. Caprotti Gresley. Conjugated southern mechanisms. Beam cataract. Centrifugal governor connecting rod. Crank. Crankshaft. Hypocycloidal gear link. Chain parallel motion plate. Chain rotative beam. Sun and planet gear. Watts linkage boilers. Simple boilers. Haystack wagon. Egg ended box. Flued Cornish Lancashire fire tube boilers. Locomotive Scotch launch water tube boilers. Babcock single and double acting condenser. Condensing steam locomotive jet. Kirchweger Watts separate pickle pot. Surface other crosshead. Cutoff expansion valve. Hydrolock piston. Reciprocating engine return. Connecting rod. Engine six column beam engine. Steeple engine. Safety valve. Steeple compound engine. Stroke working fluid. History precursors. Savory engine 1698. Newcomen engine. Newcomen memorial engine 1725. Fairbottom Bob 1760. Elskar engine 1795. Watt engine. Beam Keneal engine 1768. Old Bess 1777. Chasewater mine engine 1778. Smethwick engine 1779. Resolution 1781. Rotative beam. Soho Manufactory engine 1782. Bradley Works engine 1783. Whitbread engine 1785. National Museum of Scotland engine 1786. Lap engine 1788. High pressure Richard Trevi. Thick puffing devil 1801. London steam carriage 1803. Colbrickdale locomotive 1803. Penn Y. Darren locomotive 1804. Compound Wolf's compound engine 1803. Murray Murray's hypocycloidal engine 1805. Salamanca 1812 high-speed. Porter Allen 1862. See also Glossary of Steam Locomotive Components. History of Steam Road Vehicles. Cugnos Fardier A Vapor 1769. Murdoch's Model Steam Carriage 1784. Lean's Engine Reporter. List of Steam Technology Patents. Modern Steam Stationary Steam Engine. Timeline of Steam Power Water Returning Engine.